Sarah, we know you from Shark Tank. Kevin O'Leary invested in your company a few years ago. Give us a brief overview of Honey Fund.
So Honey Fund is a honeymoon gift registry where wedding guests can make couples' dreams come true by contributing to a dream honeymoon on our platform.
And how do you make money?
So Honey Fund has a couple different revenue streams. If you watched our Shark Tank episode, you know that there's some transactional revenue that we earn from the payment processors that deliver the cash to the couples. We also have great advertising partnerships with some of the nation's largest retailers and travel companies. And finally, we offer a freemium model, which is, if you remember back in the day of Flickr, where you could sort of have the free service and then upgrade for a one-time fee, that's where we got the idea back in 2005. And so we have a product called Honey Fund Elite, where people can pay $40 for a one-time upgrade and get a whole bunch of customization tools on their wedding registry page.
And we've been seeing millennials especially take more advantage of experiential spending. So the honeymoon, I would imagine, has taken on extra importance, right?
Absolutely. Millennial wedding couples are already seeking experiences more than things in their life. They are getting married a little later. They're less likely to already own a home, so they don't really need as much of the traditional wedding registry products that you see in previous generations. And what they really crave is a great experience. And what a better gift than the gift of a lifelong memory of a honeymoon, a dream honeymoon.
And you have this new partnership with Target. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so Target really saw this trend that we just talked about, and they wanted to find a way to serve Target guests, customers signing up for their wedding registry with not only the time-tested and loved products that Target offers, but also honeymoon and experience giving. So they called us and asked us if we could make that happen for them, and we said enthusiastically yes.
So tell me how the money, the expertise, the mentoring from Kevin O'Leary boosted the trajectory of the company.
Being on Shark Tank has been absolutely life-changing. I think the biggest thing for me as a female CEO in technology and an entrepreneur, a businesswoman, was that I was pushed into really learning about running a business and thinking about a business from the perspective of an investor like Kevin. Kevin challenges me every day to go bigger with the company, to think about the challenges that we face and turn them into opportunities, and never to quit. He's a very courageous business person, and he knows that, you know, there are key principles that make businesses successful. And when he can teach those to his Shark Tank entrepreneurs, everybody wins. The customers, the businesses, and Kevin himself as an investor.
So yeah, what would you say is the biggest sort of lesson you've learned from Kevin over the few years you've been working with him?
Kevin is really good at managing people and teams to achieve an objective. And so one of the biggest lessons learned from Kevin is how to hire the right people and manage them well. And this is something that every entrepreneur, when they turn their idea into an actual business, those are two different things. When you start a product or a service like Honey Fund, it's just a thing that people use. But if it's going to be a profitable business, you're going to have to hire people, you're going to have to manage them well, you're going to have objectives that they're clear about, that you're clear about, that you can all agree to meet together. And Kevin's really good at helping us kind of think about how to do that.
So what's next for you? Where do you see this going in terms of an exit plan? I mean, we are sitting at the NASDAQ in Times Square.
Yeah,
you know what that
yeah,
might mean.
Yeah. Well, we recently moved the company from Silicon Valley to Tampa Bay Area in Florida. We were really looking for a way to grow the company faster, to hire more talent at a cost that the company could afford, and thereby grow the company in anticipation of an exit. My husband Josh and I have been at Honey Fund for 12 years, and we're ready for the next stage of life for the company and for ourselves. We're absolutely enjoying the ride. We're not going anywhere anytime soon, but we know that an exit is on its way, and we're really looking forward to seeing how that shapes up.
So maybe an IPO?
Well, I don't know if that's on the table, but you never know. I mean, with blockchain, anything's possible with a company that deals in financial transactions.
All right, Sarah Margolis, Honey Fund co-founder. So great to meet you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Scott.